washing our hands has become very important during the current pandemic. Most of us use a soap dispenser. But have you ever wondered how a soap dispenser works? How does it magically lift up the fluid just by a simple press? Let's find out on today's episode.
Hi, I'm Nikhilesh.
And I'm Kushal.
And we're the two broke scientists. Soap dispensers come in many forms. But at home, you probably use one of these. Now, the idea behind these kind of soap dispensers is to move soap from a reservoir into your hands with just the push of a button. Basically, that means you have to move the soap against gravity. And there are a couple of ways you can do this. You can either push the soap up, you can pull it, or you could use a combination of both.
As you might have guessed, the soap dispenser we showed you works by pulling the soap up. But before we explain what causes this pulling force, let's look at the different parts of the soap dispenser. The parts include a tube, a small ball, a spring which connects to the ball, the piston, a valve, and the cap.
Alright, let's look at how a soap dispenser actually works. So here, I'm going to take the top portion of the soap dispenser, which is where the whole mechanism actually is. And I also have some colored water. Now, to simplify things, I'm going to break this down into two steps. First step is when I push the cap down. And the second is when I release the cap. Now, in the first step, when I push the cap down, there are a couple of things which happen. First, there's a ball that's hovering between the top part of the system and the bottom part of the system, which gets lodged at the junction between these two parts when I press the cap down. This means that there's no air or fluid which can move from the top part of the system through the bottom part into the reservoir when I push the cap down. The second thing that happens is now that there's a piston that's attached to the cap, and when I push the cap down, the piston moves down and opens a valve at the top of the system. So now that basically means that there is a pathway between the top portion of the system and the atmosphere. And as I keep compressing the cap, whatever fluid that I have here is now forced to come out through the cap. Initially that's air and later that's soap. Coming to the second phase, when I release the cap, again, a couple of things happen. First, the ball is now free, the ball that was lodged between the junctions is now free to move up, and the piston goes back to its top position and closes the valve. When the valve is closed at the top, that means that no air can enter back into the system through the cap. So now if you remember, during the compression phase, whatever air was at the top part of the system was expelled out. And now, because of the valve being closed when I move back up, there is a slight vacuum that still remains in the top part of the system. And this vacuum is exactly what causes the pulling force that causes the soap to move up into the system. So, just to show you a little demonstration here, I'm putting my system into the colored water. Initially, when I press the cap down, air escapes from the system and no soap comes up. But when I release the cap, the soap, or in this case the colored water, is pulled up because of the vacuum that was created in this top part of the system.
So that's the basic mechanism of how a soap dispenser works. But wait, like we told you, when you press the cap, the soap rises up the tubing. And it stays there even after we release it. But what makes the soap not fall down? You might have seen this trick many times with a straw. When you suck the fluid through a straw and then close the top with your fingers, the fluid stays in the straw and it doesn't fall back down. Simply put, the pull created by the partial low pressure between your finger and the straw balances the gravity and keeps the fluid in place. That's exactly what happens in the soap dispenser. The vacuum created when the cap goes back up keeps the fluid in the tube and doesn't let it fall into the reservoir.
Isn't that just an ingenious mechanism? with just the push of a cap while defying gravity every day at home. Now, a very similar principle is used in many places. You might have seen some hand pumps that are used to pull water out of the ground reservoirs, or even the spray bottles that you see at barber shops or you use to disinfect your house use a very similar principle.
We are all stuck at home during this lockdown period, but there are hidden gems all around us. Maybe it's time for us to observe these hidden gems and then share what you found out either in the comment section or with your friends and peers.
Thanks for watching the video, guys. We hope you enjoyed it and also learned about the physics behind a soap dispenser. Stay safe, maintain social distancing, and don't forget to keep washing your hands. Bye!